What's up, everyone? My name is Part of My Presence, and you are listening to the Part of My Presence YouTube channel, where I address common issues from a unique point of view. It's also a place where I pardon a space for critical thought and analysis in today's society, where well-informed logical assessments are slowly becoming taboo. What's going on? What's going on? Part of My Presence YouTube channel. Let's discuss Vlad TV and all of the rumors that are going on with him being... the feds, he's working for the FBI, he works for the police, he gets people jammed up all the time. And it seems that whenever someone in hip-hop, especially rappers, go on his show to talk about their past life, their past dealings in criminal activities, it always seems to come back and haunt them, where there's some type of investigation that occurs, and they often cite Vlad TV interviews. Now, one of two times, is a coincidence, but when it happens so many times as it has with AR Ab, Casanova, who else? A few other people as well too, right? There's a few that I'm forgetting to mention as well, but they'll come back to me. But there's been a few people who gotten hemmed up by what they said on Vlad TV. Now, here's what I say about this, because I don't believe Vlad TV is working for the FBI. But I do believe that his style of interview is done purposefully as an interrogation style. In the sense that he is placing the camera dead on the subject, he's out of the camera's view, we just hear his voice. So he's completely off camera, and the focus is on the interviewee. And that's done on purpose. It places all the emphasis on the rapper, on the person being interviewed. You catch not only their words, but you catch their demeanor, you catch the body language, you pretty much catch everything. So to me, I feel that was done purposefully. But as far as what these rappers say to Vlad, that is on them. No one's forcing them to have these conversations with Vlad. No one's forcing them to answer these questions. Right? There's a lot of people who are saying, well, they opened their mouths, and that's very true. Because if you think about the first 48 and how you have the police asking people questions, you have the right to say, I will not discuss it by day. You have the right to say, I want my lawyer. Right? And it's probably more evident in those circumstances because they realize exactly what they're dealing with, they would know the danger that they're in if they're in an interrogation room with police. But in this certain situation, you're in a room that has a drum set at the back, and you feel you're doing this to boost your views and your streams and to further enhance or boost your career. So you do this with the intent that you're going to become a big star, because Vlad has, I believe, 3 million subscribers on YouTube alone. And he gets a lot of clicks on his website. And in this world where everything's about social media, likes, clicks, views, if you subscribe to that type of measure stick, then you're going to look at Vlad TV as the pinnacle. So there's this pressure by, I'm pretty sure, the record labels to push them into do an interview with Vlad TV, to encourage them to be more out there, to be more visible, to have more exposure. So of course, it's going to come as a plus to go on a show or go on a website like Vlad TV and get interviewed. They might decide not to do an interview with, say, Cheese, or do an interview with Doggy Diamonds, or other lesser tier outlets. But they'll jump at this opportunity to do an interview with Vlad TV. And that want, that desire, Vlad TV uses it as a trade-off, because he says himself that he doesn't pay people for their interviews. Now, I don't believe that. It was actually exposed that he does pay certain people like Keefy D and a few others. But for the most part, especially the younger artists, he doesn't pay them. Because what he says is that in exchange for you giving me all that information in the interview process, you are going to get a lot of views, you're going to get a lot of exposure, and that will help you sell your books, that will help you sell your clothing, merchandise, that will help you sell your records, that will help you put you on Billboard charts, and that will also help with getting people to know who you are and for them to click, like, and subscribe on your platform. So that's the trade-off. So when people say that you don't have to discuss these things with Vlad, they're absolutely right. And the onus is on that person to say, no, I won't discuss this, or next question. And we had certain artists go that route, like Pee Wee Longway. You had Conway the Machine not discussing what happened in regards to, you know, the shooting that he ended up in. So you have many rappers who have pleaded the fifth. Rightfully so. And which would have been the smart thing to do. But you have other rappers who pretty much gave their whole life story and told all of their dirty deeds. Some even gave up names, locations, years, what drug they sold, what house they hustled in. So it has people saying, what the hell's going on? Okay, but here's what I want to focus on right now. Although these artists are the ones who are deciding to answer these questions for Vlad, and ultimately it's their own words that put them underwater or put them under fire, and no one's forcing them to answer these questions, who is forcing Vlad TV to ask these questions? What pressure is Vlad under that he has to ask musicians in the music business about their criminal activities that may or may have not been in their past? Why is it important for Vlad to ask those questions to put on his channel or to put on his website? When I go on Vlad TV, I'm not looking to find out what Casanova did when he was in jail, as far as stabbing people up and slicing people with the ox cutter and whatnot. I don't care about that. Yes, it's good to know someone's backstory, but I'm on a hip-hop channel, and I'm looking to get information on artists and their music, not about the criminal activity. So the question becomes, why is it important for Vlad to ask those questions? Because just like the rappers are not forced to answer, he's not forced to ask. So tell me about, you know, the drama between you and Fredo Banks. Boosie didn't want to answer that question. He didn't discuss Baton Rouge. And rightfully so. He doesn't want to cause any drama. But why is he asking him that question? Then he goes on to say, oh, you put up a picture of your trap house. Will you make $70,000? Oh, that's how you remember it? Those $70,000? Why are you asking that question? Of what relevance is it to music? It's of no consequence. If he never asks those questions again, nothing bad is going to happen to his channel, to the artist's appeal. But yet, he continues to ask each and every person that ends up in front of those drum sets about their criminal past, alleged, concocted, made up, whatever the case may be. He continues to ask them these questions. So while the onus is on the artists to decide how and if they want to answer them, the onus is also on Vlad as to what questions he's going to ask these artists, and not to jam them up. Because if he knows that his videos, his interviews, his websites are infiltrated by the authorities, law enforcement, then why doesn't he switch up the type of questions he asks? Why doesn't he decide, you know what, I'm not going to put these rappers in situations where this could be used against them? Because you already know the feds are snooping around. So Vlad, the real question towards you is, why do you continue to ask these type of incriminating questions when you know damn well that the FBI, that the police are looking at these interviews and they're using them to put people, black men, behind bars? Because I don't see you asking Russ about his criminal past. He may not even have one, but the point I'm making is keep those questions off Vlad TV. Keep those type of incriminating topics off your platform. And maybe less rappers will be indicted for criminal activities that they may or may not have gotten involved in. So that's my take of the whole situation. I don't feel Vlad is an informant or the FBI, but he definitely knows that the type of questions that he asks and the style of interrogation that he is involved in, he knows damn well it gets people caught up. And for some reason, I don't understand why he continues to ask those types of questions, because that's completely within his own power. Unless maybe it's not. Maybe he's given these questions to ask. A lot of times when these rappers are there in the hot seat, the rappers are surprised that Vlad knows some of this information. How does Vlad know about certain beats that happen in the industry? Unless he's being tipped off. And he's being fed these questions to ask these rappers so that the law enforcement, whoever's watching, can now obtain information that they wouldn't be privy to because they can't get close to these rappers. Think about it. Right? Think about it. How does Vlad know these things? Who's tipping him off? He's never given that information up as far as his sources, but hey, I don't want to speculate too much, but that's something that people need to start asking. Why do you need to ask these questions? Until next time, part of my presence, like, comment, subscribe. Peace.